Oh, I'd have to say that we've joined the ranks, and our family is indeed busy. Our children enjoy many extracurricular activities, sporting events mainly, and we try to do as much of it as a family, whether that just means riding there together and hanging out before the game or after the game, or making good use of our time. Having said that, we also guard our time at home. And we do say no to activities. We do draw our boundaries when we can see that our family is becoming ragtag, that we're tired, that we just need time at home. And that's crucial in order to be able to function and function well.
But saying no and just guarding that, when you can sense the family needs that break, and then just to shut it all off and just say, okay, tonight's family night. Mm-hmm. And whether it's you structure it to a specific night or you have to float it, but you have to be very intentional in saying, okay, we're gonna grab this night, all of a sudden schedule cleared, and we're gonna take, you know, just unwind as a family.
I think busyness is something that's an everyday challenge. You know, we wake up in the morning, and like I said, I mean, even when I get up in the morning, the first thing that's going, I'm thinking about what's coming up in the day. So I just think that's something that, absolutely, are we busy? Definitely. You know, we have six kids, and I have a business, and you know, life is crazy busy. But I think one of the things that I'm starting to learn after, you know, 34 years is that I have to make a choice and a decision to not allow busyness to keep me from the great things.
We're busy just by the nature of the fact that he owns a business, I homeschool, we have six kids. There's no way to avoid busy. But there is a way to avoid too busy, and so we make choices between good and great. And right now, I mean, our season of life is with a young family, very, very much at home and together.
For us, we start our days off in the Word with our boys, just a little devotional, and then spend some time praying. And we're doing some scripture memory right now, which is much easier for them than it is for us. They learn a lot faster than we do, but it's really good. We're all growing in that area. And, you know, then we just try to look for opportunities throughout the day to connect what we're learning in the Bible to just everyday life, these biblical truths that we're learning, you know, to just bring it into what's going on in our day. So we try to keep that, the prayer and the teachable moments and all that, look for those. Sometimes you have to be really intentional and look really carefully to find them, but they're usually there.
Thank you. still fresh.
He's filming you.
It does not get any better than that, Benjamin.
So hardcore.
They are the Led Zeppelin of this generation.
They were truly angry. Truly angry young men.
The music, the speed, the heaviness.
They're always heavier than everybody else.
So brutally heavy, I'm like, yeah, that's great.
I've just come home so beaten and bruised and bloody. You know, I broke two ribs at this show.
That's so scary.
Lift up the pillow.